So you feel the city is deadly? Are there no people living in the city?
The people living in the city are born in the city. My daughter, I gave birth to my daughter here in the village. So how can I allow her to go to the city and go as the only her?
You're correct. But do you know your daughter?
I know my daughter now. I gave birth to her. I trained her. I gave her a very good home training. I took care of her now before untimely death took his father away. Eh?
Are you sure you really know your daughter?
What kind of question is this? I know her now. Has she offended you?
You don't know your daughter. If you know your daughter, you will allow her to go to the city.
Eh?
All you owe her is to double your prayer for her.
Eh.
Yes. Be praying for her because that is what she needs in the city. Let her go to the city. You trained her well. She will not become a prostitute or anything. Because you trained her well.
So, what you are saying to me, Messi, is that I should allow my daughter to go to the city.
Okay, I've heard what you said. I will allow her to go to the city. Thank you, my dear.
Because if you allow her to stay here, there is nothing here. I don't have one big kill at
issue.
I went to see
Yashegun. Ben.
So from there I came here.
It's even good you came here because I was thinking of coming to see you for this same matter. Okay, my dear. Here we go. God bless you, my dear. Odabo. Go back and kill you. Odabo.
Ah, Tori Oni. Eh? Omo Fumi. Oluwa Fumi Layo. Made Olo. Abi? No more verses. Yes.
Solution. That's the way God.
Mommy. So what? Mommy.
Eh?
We spoke about something before your friend came in.
Uh-huh. And so what?
Mommy, me like Beshin Shay. You mean like Beshin Shay. Mommy, we spoke about something before your friend came. Now you're behaving as if you didn't speak about anything. Mommy, like you.
Oh, like you.
I like you.
Go. Mabo, you will go to the city.
Irani.
You have my blessings.
Oh, Mommy.
So you can go in and start packing.
Right away, Mommy.
Yes. But one thing you will do for me is that you will make sure you call me every blessed day.
Mom.
So go and collect Mama Jide's number.
Okay, Mom.
And when you get there, buy a small phone.
Sure.
Small phone.
Sure.
That you'll be calling me with every day.
Mama.
Let me hear your voice.
Mama. Mama. I have everything figured out. Just trust me.
You don't need to worry.
Okay, Mama. All right. Let me pass that. Mommy. Mommy.
There's nothing the Almighty cannot do. When you call on Him, He'll help you. He knows the unknown truth, and in time reveal the truth. The wicked will be punished, and the innocent, will flourish.
When you call out the gas,
how was your day?
Stop.
What is wrong with you?
My day is just as usual, you know. You asked me not to work, so I'm here. Coping with boredom every day.
I told you that I was going to get a good job for you. I don't want you to work for someone else.
It is not as if I don't believe you, okay? I do believe you. But I'm not the type that likes being idle. You should know me by now.
I know. The thing is, I want to get a good job for you that can move your kind of business. I don't want you to go outside now and be looking for customers that will come and patronize you.
It's okay. Just be fast about it. That's all I asked for.
Yes, ma.
Thank
yes,
you.
Ma. So once I'm done eating, I'm going to go see two more agents.
Two more agents?
So that it can be easy for me to get a shop for you.
Won't it cost you too much registering with two more agents?
They're asking for any money. So please, okay. I'm very, very hungry.
Yeah, sure. Let me get your food before it gets cold.
What's even a thank you, Beck? Are you serious?
You want a thank you, Beck?
Yes.
I am not only going to give you a thank you, Beck. I'm going to give you a thank you back.
It cannot work.
No.
Hey, babe. I have to go now.
Now?
Yes, now I have to go before the close.
Okay. Okay, no problem. And please be specific with the kind of shop you want. You know these agents, they will start showing you shops that can't contain two chairs.
Trust me. I know what my baby wants. I know you cannot settle for less. Mm-hmm. So let me rush. Let me rush.
Wait, wait, wait. Are you sure you're not forgetting something?
What's that?
You came in here this morning and you were saying I forgot to give you a welcome kiss. Now you want to go without giving me...
Listen to me.
No, I'm taking it.
Point of correction. I asked you for a peck. You didn't give me. Now you're asking me for a kiss. Secondly, it is one. One.
You're not doing this. You're not.
Bye. Madam, no bye bye. Hey, Buka.
Yes, sister. Ah, Mama! Welcome. Welcome.
Where's my son?
He's fine. He just stepped out. So, Mama, let me have your bag.
No, don't worry.
Welcome, Mama. Should I get you water to bathe?
No, don't bother yourself. Instead, get me water to drink.
Okay, Ma. I'll be right back.
Right, Ma. Ni nka ukwa no yebi kokwa. Eh? Chukwebuka.
Yeah.
Oh? Kuyuko.
Mama, how was your trip? Here, Ma. Thank you, Ma. Mama, let me take the
food. No, don't bother yourself. Let me sit here and wait for my son. Thank you.
Oh, okay, Ma. I'll be inside, Ma.
How can I?
How long have you been here? You didn't even tell me that you were coming.
Chukwebuka. Is that the best way to welcome your mother?
Welcome, Mama.
Eh?
Welcome. But you didn't tell me that you were coming now.
Anyway, I'm sorry. I should have informed you. But my phone spoiled before I even thought of coming here. And I couldn't repair it. The most important thing is that I am here.
Why didn't you repair it when you left Atichinere's place?
Eh? Give my phone to those boys. Those boys in Oka. After what they did to my last phone. I won't even try you to. As a matter of fact, my phone is right here inside my handbag.
Oh, you brought it here for
repair? Yes, I did.
When I'm leaving on Monday morning, I'll take it out for you to repair.
Oh, the man.
It's a good name. Welcome, Mama. So I'll soon prepare something for you to eat.
Once again, Onye Wufumi. Chukwebuka. Onye Wufumi. Eh?
You're coming from a far distance. You'd have at least eaten first.
So because I came from a long journey, I should collect food from somebody that I don't even know. Eh, Chukwebuka. I am not a hungry woman, no. Your mother is not a hungry woman. So you don't expect me to be collecting food from strangers.
This is my house. Mommy, you're not comfortable. This is my house and you're coming from far. You'd have at least eaten first.
I will not eat. Chukwebuka, I will not eat. I don't know her. By the way, what are you even doing with Onye Femano? What are you doing with Osno Fumiko? Onye Femano? Chukwebuka.
Mama, don't worry. Let's go inside, rest, and you eat. Oh yeah, I'm here now.
If not, ask him. I say, who is that?
Mama, I will tell you everything that you know that you need to know about Fumi. Let's go. I will carry the bag myself. Welcome, Mama.
My solution. Welcome. There is nothing the Almighty cannot do. When you call Him, He'll help you.
Yes,
Ma.
I call Radio.
Yes, Ma. Yes, Ma.
So that, yeah. Did my daughter Fumi come to collect your number?
because she went to the city today and I told her, come and go to Yashegu's shop and collect her number so that when she gets to the city, she will use your number to call me and I'll get to her.
She didn't come.
Eh? And your number? Fumi did not come and collect your number from you.
No.
Ah, I'm a date, Pami. I am finished. Fumi did not come and collect your number.
My number.
Koda, Koburu. Kora, Jeno.
Yes, ma'am.
Kaga, ya.
I don't know what I'm
doing. Wash him. Ajeno na malo.
Se fun mi lo se ko ni.
Mi mo boyo lo.
Nja wo lo lo.
Ko debi. Mi mo boyo jo to lo.
O lo se rin rin en ko.
A mo.
So mama, that's why she's here with me.
Mm.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Because I was surprised. I knocked and one yellow papa just came. And mama, come in, enter. Mama, welcome, welcome. Please, enter, come in. Come in, let me give you water to beat. Okay, say me.
At least now you've known who she is.
I now know who she is, only that I have a problem how she welcomed me.
Oh, really?
I mean, she just welcomed me without...
Oh, sorry. I'm sorry, mama, if she was rude to you. I don't know, it might be maybe because she doesn't know you or something.
Yeah. Chukwe Ebuka. Ibiakwa. Why are you putting words into my mouth? Did I say that she was rude to me?
Sorry, mama.
Did I say that she was rude to me?
I'm sorry, mama. I thought she was rude to you.
On the contrary, she was too nice. How can you just see somebody, stranger? Then she just say, mama, come in. Okay, now, let's assume that. I was not who she thought I was. So she would just open my son's door. Open and my stranger would just enter inside. Is that how to behave? If he asks me, that is eye service.
Mama.
And I don't like eye service people. Pretenders do the worst. Just be real, be yourself. Like Adora. You want to go? Okay, say me fair.
Mama, what can we ever do to please you?
Let her be herself. I don't like, let her not try to impress me. Let her not do eye service. Let her just be herself and I will like her. Because me, as you see me, I'm your mother. I am an elder. And what I see sitting down, you, Chukwe Bukanwan, you cannot see it on the highest zero code tree.
That's my mother.
That girl, she's a pretender.
Hell!
I know when somebody is pretending and I know when somebody is real.
No problem, mama. When she comes, I'll ask her. I guess she must have a reason why she did it.
She has a reason. And let's see, if she had just been herself and I take offense, then she will explain herself and will understand. Mm. That is how to do things. Natural. Not you just see me. Mama, come in, enter house, and let me give you water to bathe. Nonsense.
Oh, but that's fully for you. That's what she is.
I don't like eye service people.
Hey! Hey! You have carried your trouble from the village. You packed it to Atichinele's house. Now you're coming to drop it here.
Is that what?
Hey! Yes, it was.
Your mother is not a troublemaker. So, Chukwu Ebuka.
Yes, mama.
You have to try and do something about it. You never want.
Yes, mama, but you know I'm trying my best already.
I know you're trying. I'm just encouraging you to try more.
It's not easy. It's not easy at all.
Because, you know, when the rains will come, it will affect it. Yeah. And the rains will soon be here.
Yeah, that's true. Like, remember last year, it rained very heavily. And it's almost raining season again this year. So,
mm-hmm. So that's why you have to try and hasten up.
That's what I can do, mama.
Don't worry. The good Lord will make a way for you. God will open up the windows of heaven for you. So that the showers of blessing and His provision so that I can finish that project.
Thank you very much, mama. Thank you, mama.
Chukwe Buka. You're not saying amen to my prayers.
Mama, I'm saying amen in my mind now.
Chukwe Emeka, Mekolo. Put your mouth and say amen. So the angels will hear you and even support you.
Mama,
say amen.
Amen to all your prayers.
Amen.
Mama. Mama, the prayer warrior.
Those of you know that prayer is the key. That we good mothers, that is what we use to support our children. Oh, I'm going to make a way for you, Nugo.
babe. Well done. So, quick one, yeah? I want to quickly discuss something with you.
Okay, there's no problem.
Yes, there's no problem. I don't want Mama to know that we're getting married. As a matter of fact, I don't want her to know that we're having an affair.
Why? Doesn't she like me?
How won't Mama like you? Did you do anything to her for her not to like you?
That is just why I'm so surprised. What happened?
Okay, don't be surprised. I've already told her that you are. So let's leave it like that. Please.
But Ebuka, what is your reason for this?
I have my reasons. I know what I am doing. Can you trust me? Just do what I have said. Okay?
Okay. It's okay.
Are you angry?
Angry? I am not angry. You said you know what you're doing, right?
I know what I'm doing.
No problem. It's alright.
I'll be in the room. When you're done.
She will collect
Mama
Jide's number.
She did not collect it, oh. I asked Mama Jide. Mama Jide said that my daughter did not come and collect it. Hey!
Why did she do that now?
I don't know for my daughter.
How are we going to know whether she's alright or not?
I don't know. I don't know. She has finished me.
Oh.
I don't know what to do. Hey! Only one daughter. Hey! Father Lord, please. Send her back home. Send her back. Send her back. If not for you, she wouldn't have gone. You know I didn't want her to go before. I did not want her to go to the city. City is too big now for a young girl like that.
Calm down. Oh. Calm down. Eh? Calm down.
Oh, I've had it.
Don't worry.
Oh,
eh?
Oh.
God will protect her.
Amen.
Don't worry yourself. Don't worry. She'll be fine.
Okay.
Eh? She'll be fine.
Okay. Okay.
Don't worry.
Oh, I've had it. Thank you very much. Hey! Okay. What you gonna say?
She'll be fine.
Okay.
She wants your money.
Oh my God, she's so money. What, we're making?
She'll be fine.
Okay. What you go? What's she?
It's not bad, Dura.
Mom, bad, Dura. I prayed so much. And I know.
It's not bad, Dura.
Yes, Mom, bad, Dura. Mom, bad. I've been praying for her to call me or come back to the village. Gently.
Sure. Mama.
Oh, sorry, it's not so early.
Yeah, it's normal. You must have been so tired.
Yes, I'm so tired. How do you feel? Sorry. It's not that rest.
Are you sure you don't need anything?
It's what?
Food.
By this time. I just ate by 10:30. Why should I be eating now?
Mama, it is too early.
That is too early.
Yes, ma.
So you want me to eat again? Did I tell you that I was hungry? Or did I tell you that I'm hungry?
Mm. But can I get you something light?
I said I don't want you to eat again. Get away. Is it my fault? Eh? You're forcing me to eat. Me? Am I a chicken?
Mama.
Am I a chicken that eats at will? Every time church I'll be eating. I just ate by 10:30. Now you're forcing me again to eat. I said I don't want to eat, you're forcing me.
Mama, it's just...
I said I don't want to eat, that much I want to get out. It's not by force. You got to look at the book.
Mama, I'm sorry.
Come. One femana. They sent you to me.
No, Mama.
Did they send you to me?
No, Mama.
Which one is my eye service? Which one is my eye service?
If I want to eat, this is my son's house. I'll enter the kitchen. I'll go and take food and eat. You don't force me to eat when I don't want to eat. Oh, again.
Mama, I just want something.
Come on, Sissi Mapo. Come, go away. This is my son's house. I'll enter inside. I'll go and you're forcing me to eat. Someone that just ate by 10 o'clock. What's the time now? See the time. This is just one. You want to force me to eat? I will chicken. She has just disturbed my sleep.
Succeed because God protects the innocent. Yes, indeed. Yes, indeed. You can go ahead with your evil plan.
I was coming to tell Mama something.
I saw her sleeping on the couch, so I woke her up. She just withdrew inside a few minutes ago.
Mama slept off already?
Yes, I walked in and I saw her sleeping on the couch. She must have been too tired. I even offered her something light. She said no.
Ah, you don't know Mama. Mama will not eat. She doesn't eat anywhere, even in her house.
Are you serious?
I'm telling you. She said her doctor told her about one radio program like that, that always advised her not to eat too much. I'm telling you.
Radio program. Even an old woman, I never thought she would take something like that so seriously.
You don't do anything. Don't let Mama start with you. Oh. She might be old though, but she's so exposed.
I know. She's really exposed. The way she talks, the way she moves, the way she does her things. She's really, really exposed.
Don't let Mama start with you. I'm telling you. So I'll just be inside.
Ebuka, we need to talk.
Just we need to talk.
Okay, right here.
So, babe, based on what we told Mama, I would suggest that you sleep in the other room. Like, I don't want us to share the same room.
Ebuka, what did you just say?
You try to understand me.
Understand what? What are you trying to say?
Babe, I've painted this picture very well, clear to you, but you don't still get it.
Ebuka. What are you trying to achieve with all these things?
Achieve how? How do we explain the fact that we don't share anything and yet we're sleeping in the same room?
Okay. But one thing I know is that sooner or later, you see this game you're trying to play, huh? It will play right in front of everybody to see.
Sooner or later, you will realize Cherry is not giving.
Really?
Yes, I'm telling you. Trust me.
Okay, no problem.
Are you upset already?
I am not upset. In fact, get me water. I'm thirsty.
Is that what you want?
Get me water.
Alfred, I'll get you the water. Is there any water that you want?
This is getting too much. What is happening?
So to cut it short, that was the lie I had to tell Mama. I got it to play along.
But then, why did you have to lie to Mama? You should have just told Mama that Fumi is your girlfriend.
How can I tell Mama that?
Why can't you tell her that? What's so difficult in telling her that? I mean, that's exactly what it is. So you should tell her.
So I should tell Mama that I got on the streets, saw a girl, brought her home, proposed to her, and want to marry her. Because she's beautiful, haba.
If I was the one, that's the exact thing I would tell Mama.
Mama will give you a dirty slap with her left hand.
That's exactly what you deserve.
Me?
Yes, you, guy. Guy, what did they worry you now? What's wrong with you? Oh, when you know you already have a girl that you have promised marriage, all of a sudden you just show up with one lady somewhere.
I've told you I cannot marry Fumi.
makes it worse. That makes it worse. You know you cannot marry this person. Now, okay, you tell me. How do you think she's going to feel when she finds out that you're only toying with her when you're done with your so-called pleasure? And you want her out?
Chidi, it's very simple. The only thing that I have with Fumi is just a fling. I mean, the only communion we share is just to have fun and that's it.
So, I mean, easily said. It's just a fling. It's just a fling. Guy. Okay, supposing Adora shows up this period.
Adora cannot come in the next 3 months. And by then, I would have found a way to send for me off.
You sound more like a soothsayer. It's fine, but how easy do you think all of these things will be?
Jide, it's okay. I've told you, I know what I'm doing. I know what I'm doing. Leave it for me. Come on, Kimmy. He won't offer me anything.
You know, I was shocked and surprised when I saw you here. And I was like, Chukwuka is not carrying different girls. You know, boys these days enjoy playing games.
Mama, and you didn't show it that you were really that angry.
My dear, that was a civilized thing for me to do. I mean, the best for any civilized woman to do is to wait for her son to come back and explain to her. And that was what I did.
Mama, that is you. If it is some other women, seeing a girl they don't know in their son's house, the first thing they will do is start hauling all sort of insult on her. If she's not careful, they will end up beating her.
I don't forget that I live in the village. I am not timid. I am learned. I am exposed. And I was not brought up like that. Doing all that is quite barbaric. I mean, there are more civilized ways of handling issues like this.
I'm really surprised, Mama.
It's okay. So how is your mother and your brother?
They are all doing fine, Mama.
When you return home, greet them for me. You know, go?
Yes, Mama.
You know, your brother is a good person. He's well brought up and quite responsible. As a matter of fact, he was the only one that I encouraged to be around my son when they were in secondary school. Because he's a well brought up young man.
He's a very nice boy.
Adema. So, don't mind me about our man.
Mama. I am still your daughter, remember?
As a responsible mother.
It's okay.
Adema.
Yes, ma'am.
Hey, Bufa. What's up? Okay, there's someone I want to ask you. It's a very sincere question, and I want you to answer me in a very sincere way.
Okay.
You have a sister, right?
Are you okay? What are you driving at with that question?
Guy, calm down now. Why your body there rushed? Calm down. Okay, supposing a random guy, you know, finds your sister attractive, you know, I mean, notices that, you know, she's so beautiful and decides to lure her, use and dump her, how would you feel?
Chidi, forget it. I knew where you're going to already.
Guy, you don't know where I'm driving at. No, you don't know where I'm driving. Are you the one going my goal? No, you're not the one going my goal. Hey, guy, wait. On a very serious note, see, you know that the game you're playing is a very dirty one. Yes, I mean, this is really not good. Okay, supposing Mama, is having a conversation with her and tells her that you have a fiancé.
Never. What would they be discussing to that extent?
What can they discuss to that extent? What are you saying?
Are they related? Is Fumi related to us? How would Mama carry our family discussions to Fumi? Didn't I tell you who I told Mama she is?
Oh, okay. And you told Mama that Fumi is Tai's youngest sister.
Exactly.
So what makes you think that they cannot discuss that?
They can't. They cannot. They cannot. Oh.
Okay. I've heard you. God will help you.
There are some cases that God do not get involved with.
I hear you. No wahala. Let's leave it like that.
I don't even know what's... Why are you worrying yourself over this thing?
Wait, was I really worried? For what now? Guy, now your business now. Why should I be worried? Let's discuss something else.
So, my daughter, that is how it should be.
Yes, Mama. It's all right.
Okay. Fumi.
Ma.
I need to caution you on something.
Oh, what is it, Mama?
I need to caution you on how you welcomed me the other time.
Mama, didn't I welcome you so well?
No, I didn't say so. It's just that you were careless. I mean, how could you have just asked me to enter the house like that without even knowing who I was?
Mama, I knew you were Ebro Ebuka's mother.
Yeah. How would you know that I'm his mother when we've not even met?
Mama. Your pictures are in this house. I saw them and Buda Ebuka even confirmed them.
Okay. Do you know, I didn't even think that way. Even when I complained to Ebuka, I'm sure his mind never went that way too.
Mama, I knew you were the one. I can't just open the door for strangers like that. No, it's not done.
Okay, I now understand. It's okay. So just pardon me for my complaints.
Mama.
So I just needed to make it clear, to get everything clear.
No, Mama. You just corrected what could have been a mistake.
You're right.
Yes.
So it bothers me now that Mama has brought up the issue again.
But to be very sincere, it's been a very long time, I mean, that you've done anything on that house.
And if I think it should be around 6 to 7 months now, right?
7 what? Huh. It's over a year now.
Wow.
And it's almost raining season.
Is it up to that? Wow. Anyways, I mean, that's what we're saying. Eh? Ebuka, I mean, these are the things you should be thinking about. Not thinking about, I mean, pretty girls that you make your responsibilities.
So Fumi is the reason why I have not completed my house?
She's not the reason, huh?
Yes. Because, okay, the 1 month, you know, you intend to flirt with her, I mean, won't you feed her? Won't you clothe her? Won't you make her hair?
So it's money from these petty expenses that I've used to build a house.
Oh, you call it petty money, Abby? Well, it is part of it. If you save up this kind of money, it's going to make an impact on that house now.
Chidi, stop joining the two issues. Fumi's case is aside. My house case is aside.
Okay, no problem.
I'll leave you to it, but I can promise you, one day you'll come to appreciate my way of reasoning.
I appreciate it. Thank you. Just that your time is your brain used to go offline.
Thank you. And you are always on my way. with your loose brain. You don't see fine. Everything you don't do, don't finish.
Don't insult
my friend, go and finish your family house. And stop chasing beautiful girls up and down.
I'm not blaming. Let me carry my leg. Come your house.
Oh, okay, if you're tired, you can leave.
Come for Shubi, lah. Come for Shubi, come on.
If you don't see fine things like this, we just in eye, we just do.
Yeah, say you know the Porsche woman. Oh yeah. Don't forget Nami Day here with
I
you.
I know the Porsche fine girls.
Come on,
fine girls. They always they chop money too much.
Those ones they put person for busy. The ugly ones that they go spend money.
My daughter.
Yes, Mama.
You see, there's nothing as good as being well mannered. When my son told me who you were, my mind became at rest. Because your brother has been of good behavior over time. So I judge you by his behavior.
Thank you very much, Mama. We inherit our good behaviors from our parents.
I can see that. You don't even need to tell me. I mean, the few days that we spent in this house, I've seen that really you are well mannered, just like your brother.
I really appreciate it, Mama. Thank you.
And I'm not flattering you. I just want you to keep it up. Don't change you.
Yes, Mama.
Continue to be the good girl that you are. You know, go on.
Thank you, Mama. I will.
And I was so happy when Chukwu Ebuka told me that your brother has traveled abroad.
Yes, Ma. It was God that did it, actually. It is not easy securing a visa to the UK.
Did you say UK? I thought he said US.
I mean, he was in the US, then later he moved down to the UK.
Okay.
But Brother Ebuka didn't know about it. It's been long they've spoken.
I see.
Yes, Mama.
It's okay.
Let me get you something to chew before I prepare lunch.
Ah, it's the bomb, Manda.
Thank you, Mama.
It's the bomb.
Do you know what happened?
Oh, what happened, babe?
I almost messed up.
You almost messed up?
Yes. I and Mama were talking about Tayo, and I mistakenly mentioned that he's in the US instead of the UK.
Hold on. So how did you manage to cover up?
I had to lie to her. I told her he was in the US before he moved to the UK.
Thank God you were able to cover up. I trust you.
It was so close.
Very smart, bad, beautiful.
Please stop. Well, I told her that you guys have not spoken for a while. So in case she asks you, so you know what to tell her.
Yeah, leave Mama to me, that's no problem.
Honestly, that was so, so close. But you know Mama, you know how she talks. Huh? She's going to mention about Tayo again.
I have told you several times. Leave it for me to handle. You are very smart.
It is not my fault. She keeps bringing the topic up because I'm Tayo's sister, remember?
You should know how to handle this since when Mama asks you.
It's okay, fine.
Where's Mama?
When is Mama leaving?
Oh, she said next week.
Next week again? First, it was 3 days. She extended to 7, which is supposed to expire tomorrow. And now you're saying next week again?
Babe, you know her phone has not been fixed. Will she live without her phone?
What is really wrong with the phone?
Okay, the guy fixing it said he doesn't have the parts, that he has to travel to town to get the parts.
Oh God. Gradually, Mama is on the verge of spending a month in this house.
I don't understand. I thought you were already getting used to her.
The same way I am getting more and more uncomfortable. Ebuka, I can't continue to be who I am not.
Don't worry. I'm sure she will exit best week.
Look, Ebuka, it may be detrimental if she does. Okay? Because you know Mama. You know how Mama is. She'll start talking about Tayo now. You know I know nothing about Tayo.
If she talks to you about Tayo and you don't know, I believe you are smart enough to make your way out and not make mistakes.
Okay, it's fine. I've heard you. But I still don't understand why you have to hide my identity from Mama.
Get upset. What is really wrong with you? Should you go and collect the phone and fix it yourself?
So how was the interview?
Mama, those people, they are really frustrating us.
What are they saying?
Well, we did the first and the second test. Just saw their message now that we should come in for an interview on Saturday again. Can you imagine, Mama?
Is you good? It must be a very big company. I mean, they really want the best hands for their vacant positions.
Mama, I just pray I'm being selected among the chosen ones.
Don't worry. God will do it for you. God will make it possible so that you'll be amongst those selected for the vacant positions. You know, go on.
Amen.
I just wish that Ebuka, my son, hasn't got a fiancé. I would have been dusting before I leave here. You seem surprised.
No, I'm not.
Is it not good enough for you?
Mama, he's very good, you know. I'm just...
Even now that she's still in school, Ebuka would have concluded her marriage right since. And they would have even long be wedded.
Oh, she's still in school?
Yeah, she's in her final year.
And I hope he loves her.
Ah, Ebuka. Ebuka loves Adora. Ebuka, my son, is ready to kill because of Adora. So,
wow.
She's also a good girl, just like you. But that notwithstanding, it's just that she's a good girl. If not, then he asked me what I can do. I would have texted and then just shift her one side and then make sure that you and Ebuka, you know, marry each other.
No, Mama. Thank God she's a good girl, you know. I wouldn't want to snatch someone else's husband.
It's okay. Don't worry. God will also give you a good man, Inugo.
Abby.
Because you're a good girl. He'll give you a good husband. Inugo, Mama.
Mm-hmm. Yes, Mama. Mama.
Don't worry.
Thank
God
you.
God will give you a good husband, sir.
Amen.
Hey.
Just as agreed, 5 p.m. tomorrow, no African time.
Look who is talking. When have you ever kept time?
Guy, you know deep down in your heart that whatever I'm saying now is the fact. But anyways, I'm not in the mood to argue. Trust me, I'm not in the mood to argue.
Baba, tomorrow, 5 p.m.
You've not answered my question. Who's always been the one turning up late?
I'm not in the mood
tomorrow
to answer.
You will still come late.
No
way. Stopping here? You're not coming to see Mama. I've already told her you're walking me to the house. So.
You're funny. Haven't I told you? I've told you that I won't come to that your house until that girl leaves your house. I've told you.
What is your business with Fumi?
Wait.
What is your business with Fumi?
Okay, wait. You know what, see? There's something you don't understand. I have told myself deep down my heart that I do not want to meet that girl. I do not want to have anything to do with her at all. Just in case this whole bubble bursts. I am not going to be a part of the settlement or whatsoever.
No, Bobo, it's Boston. Okay. If you're not coming to say hi to Mama, it's fine. I will just tell her that you saw me to this place and went back.
Oh, good.
5 o'clock tomorrow.
Maybe it's today that all the yawa will just scatter. Let me come. No, let me come. Let me come. Let me come.
Not do anything like that. I've told you.
So you think?
Don't come again.
Don't come again.
Egbe.
You're back.
Yes, Mama.
So, how was work today?
It was fine.
No.
It's just that, you know, I don't have goods in my shop again.
Ah,
nice. So, I'll just go there to more like while away time.
You know, when you see my mother?
Yes, Mama.
Some days are like that. Don't worry.
Yes, Mama.
You will eventually pick up again.
Amen. Amen. Amen.
No.
Thank you. Oh, I've been meaning to discuss something with you.
I hope it's nothing serious.
Okay, Mama, please, this is very serious. I don't want anybody to know that I am engaged already.
Why?
You know I told you about the job that I went to apply for.
Uh-huh.
So, an insider told me that they do not accept people who are engaged or married.
Yeah, so why is it like that?
I'm wondering too. Maybe they feel like once you're married, you'll be divided from the marriage affairs and then bring it to work.
Yeah. So what kind of rubbish company is that that will not want the employers to marry or get engaged?
Mama, you know me now. You know your son now. I always have a way of doing it.
Mm-hmm.
So my plan is once I get married, before I even get married, I'll have to impress all the management so that they won't want to lose me.
I've not heard this one before.
I know what I'm doing, Mama.
Yeah.
I know what I'm doing. Mama, is everything okay?
Well, I'm just trying to meditate on what you just told me because I've not heard this one before.
There's no problem.
No problem. I was just thinking out loud. And the company not wanting people to get married.
I'm wondering too. Mama, let me take my bit.
Okay, go now so that you can eat, eh?
Yes, Mama.
Throw cheap animals. No, but wrong one. Nobody will not marry because he's working in the company.
Mama.
You don't look happy. Ogini.
Mama, this job issue is really giving me a headache.
Yeah, it is really happening. This same job issue that Ebuka is also complaining about. I mean, it's becoming worrisome.
Brother Ebuka wants a job?
Yes, he is. You know, his business has not been doing great lately. So, he has to fall back on his certificate and get a job now.
So, what is the complaint all about?
Was complaining about not, in fact, he warned me not to tell anybody that he's engaged. And the company that is looking for job, that they don't take people that are engaged or married. And he doesn't want people, he doesn't want me to tell anybody who might say to the hearing of the management of that company. And then he will lose his chances of ever getting the job.
Hey, this is serious.
I've not heard this one before.
Hey, no.
This is worrisome.
Mm.
Okay now. He has come. He's inside.
Oh, okay.
He's taking his bed.
Okay, ma'am.
So just go and get his food ready so he eats as soon as he comes out.
Mm. Okay, ma'am.
Don't worry, just take it easy. Don't worry.
Yes, ma'am. How about you? Should I serve your food too now?
As a matter of fact, I even want to go outside and take some fresh air.
Okay.
Please, it's very done.
All right, mama. Let me attend to him.
Hey, let me go for some fresh air.
Mama likes Tayo, so it's not surprising that she wouldn't like you as Tayo's sister.
When she finds out that I'm not Tayo's sister, but her daughter-in-law, will she be upset?
Once Mama likes someone, she cannot dislike the person.
Especially when she knows she's being deceived.
What is wrong with you? I told you that I know what I am doing.
There is no smoke without fire. When you see smoke, look for fire. Almost everything has a solution. When you take the right action, you find the solution. That's the way it goes.
Is Mama eating?
No.
Why didn't you tell her to join us?
She said she'll be when she returns.
Return?
Mm-hmm.
From where?
She took a stroll.
Stroll to where?
But I thought she told you before going into the cabinet.
Mama didn't tell me anything. I've told her several times. I've told Mama this is not like Auntie Chinyere's husband's village where bikes are scarce.
Hey, Buka, calm down. God is watching over her, okay?
God has been watching over her all this while. Mama cannot stay in the house for 3 days without strolling.
Well, I think she needs the strolling. It is really good for her health.
I know you will support her. You will support her. What is it?
What is what? Am I pointing a knife at you?
The one you're pointing at you is more than a knife. This is the crazy gaze.
Is this scary? Or romantic?
Well,
naughty. Okay, so let me get this off this thing before Mama gets back.
Yes, we are prepared to. This means I am coming to meet you.
Meet you where? Have you forgotten what you told Mama?
But Mama is not here. What is wrong with you? Have you not missed me?
If we are to have anything together, Mama has to be.
Please don't go far. Just wash your hands and wait for me.
No. Mama has to be around.
I will be back. It's your thoughts today, I believe. When you call him, he'll help you. Come on, babe. What is it? Would you prefer to lie on the couch rather than go inside?
What would you have me do?
Babe, come, come have a shower and come sleep. Backache if you lie down on this couch. For the first 2 weeks, you were sleeping in the room. How come you not prefer to lie on the couch?
Look, Ebuka, I find it very hard to sleep in those rooms.
Oh, no.
And besides, this is the only option I have. And besides, I'm used to us sleeping together. Ebuka. You have a fiancé, right?
Who is feeding you those lies? Where are you getting them from?
Ebuka. So you can still lie while looking into my eyes?
I do not have a fiancé. Why are you finding it hard to believe?
Okay. So who is Adora? Huh? Who is Adora, who is in her final year in school? Or is she also a friend sister just like me? Ebuka, I am talking to you. Look at me. Do you know anybody by that name? Yes or no?
A friend of mine just that bought.
Good, good. And you've introduced her to your family as your fiancé.
I do not have a fiancé. Why did I have to believe?
Mama couldn't have cooked up the story, right? She couldn't have.
Oh, I see. Mama. And you think Mama didn't say this to pull your legs?
It could have been better if she knew we are having an affair.
You know what, love? I am done having this conversation with you. Good night.
Really?
I was even on my way to come and wake you up.
I wanted to check why you're still in bed till this time, Mama.
My daughter, I've woken up since. You know, I usually wake up early so that I will pray. I have even had my bath.
I thought as much. I've even seen that. Okay, so should I still have your breakfast now?
No, it's too early. And you're already dressed up. I was thinking that you should go and sweep the compound first.
Mama, I've done that earlier this morning.
You have?
Mm-hmm.
Okwezoku. I didn't know that you were the one sweeping. I heard someone sweeping. I thought it was from the other compound.
No.
Oh.
I was one, Mama.
Ezibongwa. Imelenola. You're so hardworking, well brought up.
Thank you, Mama.
Thank you. Oh?
Thank you.
Don't worry. You see that job that you're looking for? Mm-hmm. God will provide that good job for you.
Amen.
Get that good job.
Amen.
God will give you a good husband with beautiful children surrounding your table. You're a good girl, well mannered.
Thank you very much, Mama. Mm. Thank you. So let me serve your breakfast.
Oh, then, Ma. I'm going to bring it here. I'll sit here and eat. Oh?
Okay, Mama. I'll be right back.
This is bon. Such a good girl. Imagine by this time she has already swept everywhere. Hey. I wish Chiku Ebuka was not already engaged. He should have made a good wife for him. He's gone mad.
Ebuka! Ebuka, come and eat the food I just served now. Ebuka, I'm talking to you.
Woman, let me be. Is it my first to eat?
It has come to this, right? So you're not raising your voice at me. What you did, can you try it with any other woman and go scot-free? Answer me! Or is it because the love I have for you Because I love you so much and I can do anything for you. Is that the reason why you're giving me all this attitude?
Hey, Buka, you're not the one I'm talking to. Answer me.
Come on, force me to eat. Come on, force me to eat.
I should come and force you to
come
eat.
Come on, force me to eat.
So.
Sense.
Hey, Buka.
Ogin, what is going on here?
Mama, is your son though? He did not eat anything this morning. And now he's refusing food again.
Chukwe Buka, Abuezioku. Why are you refusing food?
What is wrong with everybody? I said that I'm not hungry. Is it by force to eat?
Hey.
Chukwe Buka. You're working out on me. Your mother. It was me raising his voice up. Chukwe Buka again.
Okay. I can see that you're already getting irritated by my stay in this house. No problem. I'll go back to my house. Yes, I have to go back to my house. Biam, okay? If you're coming back, bring back my phone. Don't even repair again. Bring it back to me. Huh. Let me go to my house now.
Mama, it has not gotten to that.
It has
now.
Gotten to that. How can my old son walk out, storm out on me while I'm talking? Eh? He was even shouting at me. Eh?
Mama.
You know that before, if I come to this house, pata, 1 or 2 days, I'm gone. This time around, I have stayed for weeks. So he's not irritated. So my own son wants me out of his house. No problem. I will go to my house.
Mama.
I have a house. Let me go back to my
Mama,
house.
Take it easy.
Eh?
Take it easy.
Look at this boy.
I don't even know what is wrong with Brother Ebuka today.
Don't worry. I will go. Eh? And when I'm gone, you too, you will leave after your interview. That is when he will now miss us. And he will stay alone in this house. Nonsense. Tell me my phone. Can I be anyone? I'll be ready. You wanna?
Ni. In fact, Anna, I give them Gina that I should leave after my interview.
I don't know what is wrong with Mama. The same day that I told her not to tell anyone.
Wait, are you blaming Mama for telling her?
Why shouldn't I? The same thing I told her not to tell someone is what she went to disclose to her.
But wait, guy, do you know the reason? See, old women, there's a way they actually act. The women, they find themselves with anyone they are comfortable with. Papa, they will spill anything. Weren't you the one telling me yesterday that the two of them are not intimate?
Is that enough reason for her to spill what I told her in confidence?
Anything could have led to the topic, no? Yes, women generally, the moment they find themselves in one comfort zone where they can just talk, trust me, they will spill anything at all.
Chidi, you are getting me angry.
As how, no?
Why are you supporting Mama?
I am not supporting Mama. I am only trying to let you know that there's a possibility that she didn't even mean to say that. Maybe just slipped out of her mouth. I mean, this is how women behave.
When did I leave the house after I got back yesterday for them to have this conversation?
Okay. How about this? If you never left. Wait, are you very sure that there was no time at all that you just excused them, probably, you know, went into your room or something?
When I got back yesterday, I spent only not up to 20 minutes.
Eh? Plenty 20 minutes?
Just 20 minutes.
20 minutes.
For women, there are plenty 20 minutes. All they need is just 10 minutes.
In fact, that 10 minutes you're talking about, eh? What Mama needs to spill the whole juice and scatter everything is just 5 seconds. So.
5 seconds? I'm telling you.
Mama for my hand.
But which Mama for your hand? But wait, oh. Could it be what I'm thinking?
What are you thinking?
You know what, see, I have to hold my thoughts. Drink up and let's go and open the shop.
I'm not drinking anything.
Guy, let's go and open shop
How
now.
You say you want to tell me something and you not say it again?
Guy.
Compass.
I am the one that own what I want to tell you. For now, I want to press a pause.
Guy, let's go on.
The shop that you're going to, is it not your...
Ask me again now.
Compass, my sleep.
Let's go. Better drink up.
Compass.
If you're not ready, I am ready.
Okay, you know the pass going anywhere.
Okay, let's see now.
We'll continue this discussion now. We know they go anywhere. Compass now.
So,
GP, drop the parable and be clear with what you're saying.
Guy,
this is a serious issue.
See, what I'm trying to say is that Mama suspected that lady that she's your girlfriend. Yes. And I believe that's the major reason why she brought about Adora's case. So that by the time Fumi sees her, I mean, whatever reaction she wears would confirm her own suspicion.
That cannot be the case.
Ah.
Abba, I mean, she cannot suspect us because we didn't give her any reason to. Yes.
Yes, man. You just need to like yesterday they bore you. But dealing with an elderly person, someone that has spent quality time on earth,
a wise person at that. Guy, you the joke. So you think that you go ahead and you tell your mom that, oh, mommy, please do not tell anyone that I have a fiancé somewhere and it's going to work like that. Don't you think you're going to raise that suspicion?
But we're able to convince her now. I told her it was for the job purpose.
You thought you were able to convince her, but it did not work. Listen to me. It's quarter to go to work. I have to leave.
No. Jide. What is wrong with you now?
What is wrong with me now? What is wrong with me?
Guy, wait. Did you seek my permission before you went ahead with your game?
Did you?
Every time that I try to talk to you about something, you want to snap out of it.
For
you can't
why
go
now?
To work.
Why?
You bring your own problems to me for solution one day.
No.
I will not have such problem. Talk less of bringing it to you. No. Not this kind of problem. Not something that we actually all foresaw that, oh, this is probably going to happen.
Are you serious?
Yes.
I won't. And you're with my job.
Stay your day your lane. No.
I don't like it though. You're supposed to be my friend. I cannot bring my problems to you and say, Jide, how far? That you would sit with me and say, okay, this is how we'd solve it.
Come off it.
Why do you scare me now?
Were you meditating?
I don't like that place.
I was just trying to make you happy.
All that you will do for me now is when I see my daughter. And you see, since I had that encounter with that prophet, I've not been able to sleep.
Same with me.
And he said, my daughter, that she's alive. But she's under influence. What does that mean?
No wonder that priest. Maybe that was what that priest meant when he said that there is a dark cloud that covered his sight.
All what they say is going to be tough, because I don't go to church. Even when I was a teenager, I don't go to church. Even after I got married to Baba Fumi, I don't go to church.
Yeah, I go, but it's a long time that I've been to church. But you know, we promise to give it our best shot.
What they said, they're fasting.
You will want to need that cloud.
I mean, to more language, you throw a lot more banner calling more goodly. I want the calling more goodly or lot more banner calling more goodly to get Jesus. You should come down, worry. But they seem too far. Just because we are not for him, we are for God. That is why he's tormenting us. But I know very well that I will see my daughter.
Ah, you will see her.
God will bring my daughter back
home. Back by alone, you will see her. You will see her.
Look, we want to go to the shop. Calm down, we'll go to that shop later.
Already. See, the only advice I will give to you now
rubbish to discharge this lady as soon as Mama leaves. Because if Mama decides to mention it to Adora, Uncle, you know what that means. Adora is going to come back with loads of trouble.
Ah.
So think.
That's true. I'm telling you. I know what to do.
Okay, that's it.
I'll tell Mama not to tell Adora. Very simple.
Wisdom.
I'm good.
Don't leave me. You are too much. You two have sense. So, the same Mama that you begged not to mention for me to Adora, and she did. Guy, don't be childish now. Don't be childish.
What would you have me do? What would you have me do?
Guy, do anything you like now. Why are you making it look as if I am the one who is going to advise you about your life? Besides, the advice I have for you, I have dished it out already.
How could you say that? I mean, put yourself in my shoes. Would you expect me to just go home and tell Fumi to leave like that? I mean, without any reason. How about now, if now you tell you go vex?
Do what you like now. That was what I said. I knew my advice is probably going to be very useful. So, do what you like.
Jide, I've seen that my situations do not concern you again. I've seen that nothing about my business concerns you again. It's fine.
See, if the purpose or motive behind what you've said to me now is to make me feel bad. I'm feeling bad right now. Like, my heart is broken.
You're not okay.
You have failed. You have failed woefully because it's not going to work. Guy, I need to go and make money. You've eaten too much of my time already today. I beg, I need to go make money, I beg.
Well, I am.
We'll come back, we'll finish this in the evening.
Your face all swollen up like soaked bread. Organe.
Mama, how come the same information I told you not to tell anyone is what you went to disclose to people?
Yeah. Which information did I disclose to people?
The other day, I told you not to tell anyone about Adora's existence in my life.
So did anyone tell you that I came to tell him or her after you warned me not to disclose?
Mama.
Who told you that?
What is happening now? I know you to be someone who don't deny your actions regardless. Don't make me start doubting you.
Chukwebuka, doubt me? Like how? Biamotakira, I don't understand you. Is it that if I tell you the truth, you beat me or what?
Who told Fumi?
Told Fumi what? Tell her what now?
How did Fumi know?
Are you not the one that told her?
I did what?
Yes. She told me that she already knows about Adora when I was discussing with her that evening. And that was after you came to warn me not to tell anybody.
Fumi said I told her?
Yes, she said that she already knows about Adora's existence. So how come you're not accusing me?
It's okay. It's fine.
What is even the big deal about Fumi knowing about Adora? Or getting them? Didn't you tell me that it was because of this, the people where you were looking for a job? I don't even understand.
Mama, must you bring trouble in everything? I said it's fine. I know what I'm doing.
And what do you think you're doing? Everything. I know what I'm doing. What do you think you are doing?
Mama, it's fine. It's okay.
Yeah. You don't want people to know that you're engaged. Oh, I'm a call woman. Call but I call will give you code. Just don't put down my life. You've already discussed it with Fumi. Now you want to come and blame me. Because bro, I need that. When you plot against the innocent, you will not succeed. Because God protects the innocent. Yes, indeed. Yes, indeed. You can go ahead with your evil plan. Try to hide it.
Welcome, darling.
Thank you.
How was work today?
so.
Should I serve you?
I am not hungry.
But Ebuka, what is with this attitude you've been putting on since morning? Huh? You left this house this morning without eating anything. And now you're back and you're refusing food again. Who are you supposed to be angry with?
Did I tell you that I am angry? Did I tell you that I am angry?
Okay, fine. You know what? You need to relax. Eat, then we can talk about this.
Come and force the food in my mouth. Come and force the food in my mouth.
But Ebuka, you can't be doing...
What is it?
What is what? I'm sleeping in this room tonight.
Are you serious? Is that a joke or something?
It is not a joke, Ebuka. Look, I am tired of sleeping in the other rooms. I am going to sleep here with you tonight. Besides, my body aches.
Didn't I tell you to sleep in the other room the other day?
And I said I don't want to. I don't want to, Ebuka. Please, let me sleep here, please.
Okay, fine.
Where are you going to?
Sleep here. Or sleep in the other room.
Ebuka, this is not a matter of sleeping here or sleeping on a waterbed, okay?
I don't understand.
You don't understand what?
I don't understand. What
Please
is this?
Please tell me, when was the last time you touched me like
this? Shh, baby, you have to calm down. Mama will hear you.
I don't care if Mama hears me, okay? I am tired of being who I'm not. Please, Ebuka.
Okay, wait. What if Mama leaves tomorrow? We can continue.
Mama leaves tomorrow. Mama came here the other day. She said 3 days. From 3 days, 7 days. And now you're telling me Mama is going to leave tomorrow. See, she's not going to leave anywhere. So let's just do it in front of
Mama
her, please.
Mama will leave tomorrow.
Ezio. Chukwe Ebuka.
Mama, I can't.
So this is what you've been doing?
I can explain.
Explain what? I heard everything. Anurumi Henile. I heard everything.
Mama, it's not what you think.
What do you mean what I think? So you sleep with your friend's sister. Eh? Mom. That is what you're doing. And you have been deceiving me. Maguma, akunoku. Ashawakobakobo.
Mama, I am not a prostitute.
Hey, chill, Mama.
I'm here to see my fiancé.
Who is your fiancé?
Mama, it's late already.
Who is your fiancé?
You cause problems.
So, I was busy praising you, not knowing that you're a snake. That is...
Mama, Ebuka promised to marry me.
Eh?
He promised to marry me.
Yeah.
I am his fiancé.
Mama, who is fiancé? You're here listening to the rubbish that this girl is vomiting. Eh? And you're there standing at me like a goat. Okay? What is all this about? Can you not be showing her?
Mama, please go to your room. Mm-hmm. We'll sort this out in the morning.
I should go to my room. While this girl remains here, I'm not going anywhere.
She will go with you once you leave.
I'm going nowhere. I'm going to sleep in this room with my husband to be.
Who is the husband to be?
Mama.
You're so shameless.
Mama, I am the original owner. He did not tell you.
Husband snatcher like you. Eh? You snatched my son from the original owner. You are here claiming husband to be. You are leaving this house first thing tomorrow morning. All those your lie interview. All those your useless interview. It ends tomorrow. You are leaving this house.
I am going nowhere, Mama. Leave me and my husband alone now.
Hey, tell me who is your husband? Wasebapo. Mama. Wasebapo, son.
Mama.
Tell this girl to leave here. Ask me Sebapo.
Mama, it's okay. It's okay.
Chukwe Ebuka. You come out here. You did not tell her that your mother is a tigress. Old age cannot slow me down. I am a tedious girl. I'll beat the living daylight out of you,
Mama,
if you don't leave
okay.
Here.
Babe, please. Just avoid trouble. Just go.
Come on, Mama. Come on.
Okay, fine. I will go. But tell Mama about me. Tell Mama everything about us.
My friend could not tell.
I will go. Mama, I will go. Tell Mama about us. Mama, I am your daughter-in-law.
And
okay,
you.
Okay.
Okay.
Okay, Mama, good night.
Who good night what? Look, let me tell you, eh? I am not going anywhere until you tell me what all this rubbish is about.
Mama, go to your room. I will explain tomorrow morning.
You're not explaining anything tomorrow morning. As a matter of fact, you're explaining it now. I'm not going anywhere.
Mama, it's late now.
Start talking. I said start talking. Nonsense.
Mama,
whether I like it or not.
Tell me the reason why I should leave this
house. You leave my house. You jumped my son. I don't want any longer. I don't want. Go. Mama, go. I don't
want you. I am going nowhere.
I said you're not going anywhere.
I did not charm your son, eh. Mama. Out of my way.
It's not my fault. Mama. If I slap you, Mama. If I slap you, get blind.
Mama, what do you want me out of this?
I said you charmed my son. I no longer want. I'll charge him. Mama. Leave my son alone.
It is love that is not working. Mama, open your eyes. It is love.
I said, what is love? I don't want. My son will not marry you.
Mama.
Now leave this place. What's
Mama.
Son?
Mama. Mama, Tasha Hanya.
I said,
Tasha Hanya.
How was that again?
Tasha Hanya.
Okay, look at me.
Okay, look at me. No, no, no,
I don't want.
Mama,
I don't want. You're fighting me. I'll get this girl.
That Mama has been in this house. What has happened?
Now that you've scattered everything, has that thing happened? Not for the love that I have for you, I'd have allowed her to throw you out of the house.
You wouldn't do that. You wouldn't dare. Please, do you know what I really want right now? It's for you to go inside and tell Mama all the plans you have for me.
Babe, can you calm down? What is wrong with you? I thought we had the plans already. I've explained these things to you several times. Please, love.
I didn't do anything. I just did what was necessary. Mama is really stressing me.
She. Eh? I'm asking you, where is she?
Mama, she's inside.
Inside doing what? Somebody that I asked you to go and throw out. What is she still doing there? Hey, Buka, you're daring me, oh. You are daring me. I'll just go out now and I'll scream.
Mama.
I'll go outside now to scream to the whole neighborhood so that they will come and see how this old famous nigga has charmed you.
Mama, stop causing trouble, Mama. Why do you always cause trouble? You can't do a thing like that.
I cannot do a thing like that. I will embarrass that girl and embarrass you too. You know what I can do? You had better go and throw that girl out.
Mama, you will end up embarrassing me.
I said I will embarrass her, and if the embarrassment gets to you too, so be it. Go and throw that girl out. I no longer want her in this house.
Listen, Mama. Jerry is a great help that I need for me to do for me via her friend. And it is only for me that can do it.
So, you're saying that girl will still remain in this house?
Mama, it's just for 2 weeks. Just for 2 weeks and she'll be gone.
2 more weeks! 2 more weeks that I'll still have to dwell with that devil, that demon, under the same roof. Chukwe Ebuka, I can see that you're really under a spell. You don't even know what you're doing again. What I could offer money over a log will watch you see again. You don't even know what you're doing again, Chukwe Ebuka.
Mama, that's how long it will take me for me to achieve my aim.
Okay, on that aim, it will not succeed in Jesus' name. That aim will backfire. It can never succeed.
Mama, you're laying a curse on me.
I will lay more curses on you if that girl does not leave this house.
Mama, you can't lay a curse on me. You're my mother. Everything that I stand to benefit from this thing now, you also benefit from me.
And I don't want anything at all, Mia. I don't want to ever have anything to do with that girl. I don't ever want anything from her. At all, Mia. What I want now is for that girl to leave this house. Period.
I should go and apologize to Mama. But I did not offend her.
This is not a case of offending her or not. Come on. I just want to salvage the whole situation so that she can be calm. Please.
So what am I going to say to her when I get there?
Very simple. Just go there. tell her that you're sorry for everything that has happened, and she'll be calm. We'll move.
Ibuka, just, you just want me to do what is not necessary. What I expect you to do is to just go in there and explain everything
you
about us.
You do not understand the situation on ground.
No. Go in there. Tell Mama that I am your wife to be. Period. Nothing else.
Ha! Why are women so difficult? What kind of creatures am I living with? I speak with you right now. The house is on fire. Mama doesn't want to go back to the village again until Fumi leaves.
You don't look like you are insane, but the truth about it is you talk and act like one. To even start with, what is that girl still doing in your house?
I told you Fumi cannot leave. At least not yet.
Why can't she leave yet now? Really? Why can't she leave yet until she scatters your relationship with your mom and Adora? Really?
Okay, now I think I get it. That means your mom is right.
Right about what?
She's right about the fact that this girl don't charm you.
Can you and Mama stop this chanting already? It's getting me angry.
Yes, the more you keep thinking that we get you angry, you annoy us the more with the stupid things you say from your mouth.
Really?
Yes, you do. Really? You just say blatantly. I just want to flex with her for just like a month or thereabouts. I have my reasons. And yet, you're on the verge of scattering your relationship with your mom and your fiancé. Really? You think someone in his right senses will do that? Guy, not charm. They don't charm you.
Let me tell you the truth.
Don't tell me any truth. You don't get one single truth in your mouth. Don't tell me any truth. Go and solve your problem.
There's a secret you need to know.
Secrets. Guy, wait first. Wait. Wait till that one now. Oh God, this is what I'm talking about. Guy, I think you have mental issues. Because now only me and you day here now. Why you want to whisper from my ear? Guy, what?
I'm just being cautious. I don't want any ear to hear it.
Ebuka, you want?
Ebuka, you have your own sister in school, right?
You see why I didn't want to tell you? Because I know you would scold me for life.
Alright, so why did you end up telling me? You should have kept it to yourself for life now.
Jide, you know how things have been for me lately?
Guy, I beg, please. Just spare me that.
How has it been for you lately? Huh? How? Oh, you want to start creating excuses for your own mess ups? What did you plan by yourself? You want to start creating excuses for it?
Guy, no! You can't be making an excuse for the things you planned. It's not possible.
You must stay far from me.
Has it gotten to that?
It's gotten beyond that.
When you cannot trust a friend, then that friend is not worthy of being your friend.
See, Guy, let me tell you, at this point in time, I don't want to lose it because you want me to freaking lose it. I don't want to lose it. Guy.
From now, hence, I don't want to see you. If you know what is good for you, I do not want to see you in my house again. If you see me on the road, don't call me. Do not call my phone. Act as if you don't know me.
And you can't be serious. You cannot be serious.
So you think, Guy, leave my house now.
Ibuka should leave your house.
Else, Guy, if you don't come out now, I swear, the uppercut when I go give you.
It's fine.
Eh?
It's okay. I get it now. It's fine. I'll leave your house.
Better.
but I'm leaving because of Hunting.
My friend, leave, I beg. You're leaving for which reason? You think I don't know? You've messed up. You've messed up and you want me to come help you clean your mess up. You want to drag me on the floor like a pig that you are. I'm sorry, that wouldn't happen. Is this guy mad?
Mama. Mama, this hunger strike you're going through in this house, it will not do you any good. Please, Mama, come and eat the food I just prepared.
I am not interested in that poison that you prepared.
Is it by force? I want to cry. Why don't you let me be? I don't want to eat your food. Leave me alone, Biko. Happy Maka.
You want to charm me? You want to charm me the way you've charmed my son, okay? So must all of us be under your spell? Must we be under your armpits?
Mama, this is the second day you're not eating in this house. Mama, are you not scared of Osa?
What is your business if I die of Osa? It's not your business. Go and bring that to your mother.
Yummy.
Yes, to come and eat that your poison. Because that poison is not for me. And let me tell you, you have to leave this house because if my daughter, Ebuka's younger sister, comes to meet you after exams, both of you, it will not be easy for you.
Mama.
So you had better respect yourself. Pack your things and leave this place.
Mama, see, I did not charm anybody. I did not charm Ebuka. Ebuka loves me naturally. Mama, try to understand.
And that love will kill you naturally. That love is what is going to kill you naturally. What is all this? I said I don't want you. You're forcing me. I don't want you. You can never be my daughter-in-law. Never.
Mama, me, I'm not going anywhere. I'm not going anywhere. Sooner or later, you have to accept me as your daughter-in-law in this house.
Accept you. You have to kill me first.
Is it my fault?
Mama, come on.
I'm not eating. Come on, sit down, son. Leave this thing.
Mama, I'm waiting for you inside. Come on.
Nonsense. You won't talk. No,
Mama, come on, eat though.
Come on, Sheba, poor. I don't know. What did they even send you to my family to come and destroy all of us? You've charmed my son. You put him under your armpit. Now you still want to put me under your armpit. That one will not happen, no. Not while I'm still alive. Nonsense. That's how Yoruba charm can never get me. Rubbish. Nonsense. Takere, and go Mzurike.
Mama, good evening. Mama, I just greeted you. I expect that you respond at least.
And I said that your greeting is useless to me. That's your greeting. Is of no use to me until that Ofemanu get leaves this house.
I don't like it when you raise your voice, Mama. You're embarrassing me. I feel so ashamed.
You're ashamed of me. You're ashamed of me, your mother. As a matter of fact, you should be ashamed of yourself. You should be ashamed of yourself that witch is still in this house. What is she still doing in this house? Eh?
Mama, I have told you that Fumi will soon leave.
When? I have been hearing this thing. When will she leave? You people have been deceiving me, sis. Eh? The first time you told me that she's your friend's sister. Not knowing that this girl sneaks into your room and you will be doing all sorts of rubbish.
Mama, Okwagi, you have a potential. Okwagi? You have a potential for free. Oh.
Okwagi, at times I wonder if you're actually my son. What is that girl still doing here?
What can you say?
Eh? You want her to charm me the way she has charmed you. So that all our family, all of us will be under her armpits.
Fumi doesn't.
You can't have her, but that one will not happen.
Mama, let's go and eat.
I'm not eating. I am not eating. Which food? The food that witch prepared for her to charm me. Is that she go and eat? Yeah, no,
woman. This is my house.
Nonsense.
And the food is my food.
Then who cooked it?
Fumi made the food.
And she made, so you expect to go and eat the food of a witch. That is what you expect me.
Mama, can you stop all this?
If it can happen, man, I can just leave me alone. I am angry. I am very, very angry. Just let me be. Say my poor. Okay, we hate Capico. No, let me be. Wrong of my man. I'm a boy, but your family deceive very young again. Nonsense. You want to force me to like her? For what now? She must leave this house, though. She must leave this house. Rubbish.
What does that mean?
I don't
know.
But my instinct tells me it's not a good one.
Now, so, the thing there is, I was calling her, but she did not answer. And I was unable to, you know, to go out of the house. I couldn't. It was as if I was held captivity.
You know, dreams could mean different things. But this one is not a good one. Yes.
And so?
But how can she be in the house and you'll be calling her and she will not answer?
That's what I don't know. We still have one more day to go.
May I feel that her prayers has been answered.
Amen. So?
Maybe I should come to the house so that we can break the fast together. Then pray fervently.
That is an amazing idea, you know.
Okay. Let me hurry home.
Okay, dear.
Put my house in order.
Okay, dear.
Prepare something for us to break the fast.
No, no need. No need for you to bring any food. I will cover that.
Okay.
Yes. Just come. I'll be expecting you.
Okay. Let me quickly.
To the house and see you in the room. No problem. Thank you, my dear. So, Mama left this house without informing anybody.
Are you sure she has not gone to the village?
Her luggage is out there.
Oh. She didn't carry it.
She didn't go with them.
Then you shouldn't be worried. Probably she has taken one of her usual strolls, you know.
Mama never strolls in the afternoon. And funny enough, she was well dressed. She took her time to make up and left the house.
And you didn't follow her to know where she's going to?
I followed her to the gate. But before I could get there, she has already taken bike. I beckoned on the bike guy to stop, but he just was still moving.
Who could she have gone to? You don't know any of her relations, where she always goes to whenever she comes around?
Why are you talking like you don't know, Mama? Mama never visits anybody. I'm so tired.
She's going to come back, okay? Mommy's boy, come here. You worry too much. Mama this, Mama that, Mama that. Come on. At least worry about me too, a little. Please.
Are you sure?
Yes. I'm here for you.
Hey, my sister! My sister! My sister!
What is this, my dear?
Hey, thank God! Thank God! Oh,
what is it now?
Ah,
strength, though. I saw for me.
Eh?
Ah! She came to me. She was thanking me. Thanking me. Thanking me for standing by you. Thanking me that I did not lose hope in her. Yeah. Hey! She was looking so beautiful.
I am not saying that we are not victorious. Is it not in the dream? It's when she come back. Then I will know that God has finally done it for us.
God has answered our prayers, Joe.
Amen.
She will come back.
No problem now.
We will see her.
There's no need for us to marry now because she's not around.
We will see her. Just have faith.
I have faith now. I have faith that the Lord has done it for us.
You have
it is
faith.
When I see her, I will now know that yes, so everything is fine. You don't understand.
You will see her. She will come back to us.
Amen.
In a glorious way.
Amen.
So beautiful.
Amen.
So rejoice.
I'm rejoicing.
We are not rejoicing.
I know that the Lord will do it.
Rejoicing. God has done it.
Our God will do it for us.
God has done it.
Yes. Thank you, my dear. Thank you, my dear.
Thank you, God bless sister. You.
That is why I have a lovely friend. A lovely friend and a sister. You are not friend again. You are sister now.
Yes, so.
We are sisters. We are no more friends.
God has done it, cha.
Amen.
Say this guy don't stand for there. This guy, those two young people. If I say something, no.
No, go mind your own. How you take no say na him?
You shut up.
I beg, keep quiet, Jerry. I beg, let's talk our own. I beg. How you take no?
So when they push me, why you chant for me, sir? Ha! See this fine girl.
You too talk.
No matter to talk, that's the pain.
You too talk, shut up. I don't mind your own. What's it concern you?
Hey, person, find those stuff for there. Then see this small boy, those call, those two shots. He just carry the bag, give her.
You sure? Maybe they know each other. Leave that.
Full station, they know each other. They know go hug. I see no hey, you God. You back them. Hey, I see.
How they concern you now? No concern you.
Hey.
So. Chukwuebuka, my son, charmed a girl and brought her home. Eh? This is unbelievable. It's hard for me to believe. So he has to charm her, drugged her, and then brought her home. A woman of God.
The Holy Spirit revealed to me now that your son did not bring back the girl for relationship. But for ritual purpose.
Why would he have to charm a lady to bring her home when he has a lady? Another lady that loves him wholeheartedly. Chukwuebuka has a lady that loves him unconditionally. And I don't know him to be a flirt. Is it that he's planning to marry two wives or what? I don't understand.
The Holy Spirit revealed to me that your son went to a native doctor who instructed him that he should bring a total stranger that he will sleep for 3 weeks. At the end of the 3 weeks, he will bring back the rubber that used for the girl for ritual purpose.
I am finished. This is unbelievable. This is unbelievable. Chukwuebuka, why? Why would he do that? Why would he want to use another person's sister, another person's daughter for ritual purpose, for money making ritual? He has his own sister. He has his own sister that he loves unconditionally. Then you not want to go and use someone else's child.
As it is right now, the lady does not know what she's doing or where she is. Thank God that you came. God used you as a saving grace to save that girl life.
I did not bring him up like that. My whole life, I have never been involved with fetishism or ritual or anything. I am not fetish. So where did he learn this from? Why would he do that? Thank God that all this has been revealed. What do we do? There should be a solution to this. What do we do? To save the poor girl, the innocent girl.
The only solution now is prayer. Bring her out here. Let me pray for her to revive her.
That one is not a problem. Let me go and bring her. It's not a problem at all.
What have I done to you? What? How would you live this kind of life?
She's here. Fumi, meet the woman of God, the prophetess.
Mama, so you actually brought a prophetess into this house to expose me, right?
My daughter is not what you think. Calm down first and watch what she wants to do. Calm down.
Listen to what, Mama? Mama, let me ask you a question. Do you believe in love?
Yes.
I mean, natural love.
Fumi, nobody is talking about anybody charming anybody here. Calm down and watch and listen to her first.
Okay, no problem. Pastor, on a good day, in this house, I will not join your prayer, no matter what. But because Mama called me a witch and she wants me to be exposed, no problem. And you must expose me today. So let's start.
My dear, I'm not here to expose anybody. I'm here to pray for all of you.
Yes, she wants to pray for all of us.
Go and get your scarf.
Go and get your scarf.
Okay, I will. Mumbo. Mumbo.
Son's house.
Your son?
Yes.
Who is your son? Who are you people?
Calm down.
Where am I? Where is my mother? Where is this place?
Calm down.
How did I end up here?
Calm down. I'll tell you everything. Just relax, eh? Relax.
Okay, Mama. Let me take it from here. First and foremost, let us give glory to God.
Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus.
Please, who are you?
Father, Lord, we give you praise.
Who are you people? What am I doing here?
Thank you, Jesus. Father, Lord, I give you all the praises. I give you all the adoration. Thank you, Lord, for delivering your daughter.
Sit down.
Sit down, sir. Sit down.
Get your
hands off me. Don't touch me. Don't touch me. Don't touch me.
Jesus. Calm down. Sit down. I'll talk to you later.
Where is this place?
Thank you, Jesus.
Who are you people?
Where with you?
Where am I? Where is this place?
Hey! Hey, Chukwuebuka, where did you learn that wicked act from? Where? How? Hey, Chineke, the children of these days,
they want to make it by all means. They want to make it by fire, by force. Imagine my own child into ritual. Hey!
Hey! Hey! Chukwuebuka! Chukwuebuka!
Mama, the grandma!
Chukwuebuka!
Open this well.
So you're evil. So you're this wicked. Chukwuebuka, where did you learn all that wicked act from? Where did you learn it from? Was your father a ritualist? Your grandfather? Was he a ritualist?
Mama, I'm not feeling well.
You're not feeling well?
I don't understand. What kind of question is this?
Yeah, I don't know what I'm talking about. I'm a mad woman. I don't know what I'm
mama,
saying.
Mama, I don't understand.
Listen. I'm your mother. You cannot hide anything from me.
Mama, I don't understand all this.
You don't understand what? You don't understand what? You don't understand what? Eh?
Mama, you slapped me. After I told you I'm not feeling well.
I say Ofrogofo. yet you wanted to go and use somebody's child to go for, to go and make a ritual of where? Eh? To go buka? Eh? No here. Let me. Oh, you're surprised. Oh, Jiruganya, you are surprised. I know everything. Where is he going to? Kevin Aga. You want to go and see? Chukabuka, you want to go and confirm if really? Well, let me shock you. Eh? That spell that you cast on that innocent poor girl, it has cleared from her eyes. She has regained consciousness. Lendoge, ritualist. Hey! And let me tell you, Fumi has gone to make a formal complaint at the police station. Yes. And if you're not careful, you will rot in jail. Iga Anwu Namporo, you would rot in jail. Iga Anwu. Evil child. Where did you learn all that from? Lenum, I know I might be a troublesome woman, but heaven knows I have never involved myself in any fetish thing. So how can it be my own child, a ritualist? To fear akwa, chukwa ajo. Let me tell you, anything you do, you will repeat it.
Pastor pleaded with me
and advised me against standing as a witness in the law court against you. He told me that our family name will be tainted.
Thank you.
If not, I would have made sure that you go to jail.
Evil child. I would do that without even minding that you're my child. Eh?
Thank you, Mama.
Eh-eh. Don't thank me. I don't need that your cost. Thank you. I don't need it. You're just lucky. And in fact,
I regret accepting the pastor's plea.
I would have just gone there to testify against you. Yes, I would have done it, not minding that I'm your mother and you're my child.
Thank you, Mama. I need to rest. I'm not feeling too well.
Hey, go in and rest. You need it. Go in there and rest.
Learn okay. And I have to even warn your sister against you.
Not that you are, you failed trying to use a stranger. Who knows? The next time they might even advise you to bring your mother or your sister.
God forbid.
Then you not come.
I will advise your sister to be very, very careful about you. Because yes, you might use us.
Mama, I will never do it again. I swear.
You will not do it again. Hi, Chukwebuka. Get it here again now, Joe Mama. I did not bring you up like that.
Ego mbute o.
Each of you was each of you butego by fire by force. I brought you up in a godly and a proper manner. You now grew up and decided to go your own way. When I go back to the village, I will gather all your kinsmen.
No.
Tell them that you attempted to dent our family
Mama,
name.
Please. If you do that, my image will be dented. I won't be able to enter the village again.
So did you think of that, your image, when you attempted to use someone's daughter for ritual? You did not think about it, Okwe? Okay? And if you go in there, you had better go and look for money to give to that poor girl. Let her start going back to her village. And I know ya. Eh? Am I even sure that you're not the one that stole her money?
Yes. You know, because I don't trust you again. I don't trust you. You're now very, very wicked. Meanwhile, I did not bring you up like this.
Who did this to you? Chukwuebuka, I did not bring you up like this now. Obro no kam sezwogi. Eh? Please, go and look for money to give to her. Her friend is already waiting for her. So that first thing tomorrow morning should be on her way. In Anuya?
Mama, I cannot go in. Let me go and look for the money.
You want to go and look for money? Nguanu, kam basaragi. Lenu thod, lenu. Hi, children of these days, I don't understand. They want to make it by all means, by fire, by force. Any day that you mention my name or my daughter's name, in all any of those, your Holy Ghost fire will consume you. Nonsense. My daughter.
Mama.
You're ready to go.
Yes, ma. Thank you very much, mama. Thank you, Rebecca.
Yes.
Thank you.
So that's why, as I explained to you, by the time he touched you, you fell under hypnosis. So I gathered my boys before we could get him. And not away with it. If I couldn't get him again.
But how did he know you guys were onto him?
There's this charm that people use now. Once they use it, anytime they're in danger, it will alert them. I'm telling you.
Wow.
Oh, it will never be well with those boys though. It will never be well with them.
No matter your children too. They will repent. God will help them.
So did you report to the police?
Ah, we couldn't report to the police. So. Nobody has the time to go to the police to report every day. So they just said that I should keep you depending on when you regain consciousness.
So, how did I end up in your house?
We had a meeting and they decided that I should be the one to keep you till you are stable.
Thank you.
It's okay.
Mama.
Hey, Mom.
Thank you so very much.
Thank you, my daughter.
Thank you. Thank you, Mama. Please, I want to ask you something.
Okay.
During my stay in your house, did anything happen between us?
Anything like what?
I mean, you and I, intimacy.
Oh, no. As Mama, we are godly people. We are Christian family. I can't take advantage of your predicament. No.
I'm so sorry. I just needed to know.
It's okay.
Thank you, Boy Buka.
It's okay.
Mama, thank you so very much. Thank you, Ma. When I get to the village, I and my mom will come and say very big thank you to you.
No need for that. God will take you safely back
Amen.
Home. You
know,
go, when you get to the village, make sure you call me to your mother's phone so that I can also talk with her.
I will.
Amen.
Thank you for taking care of me. Thank you.
Thank you, Ma.
Tomorrow. Through Mama's phone, and she sent me some money, so that's what I'm going to use for my transport.
Okay, you know what will happen? I'll add to the magic. Yes, it's okay. Well, immediately the guy touched you that day, your money vanished.
Hey.
I'm telling you.
Wow.
Don't worry. Let me help you with your bag. Don't let it bother you.
Thank you, Mama.
Bye, Mama.
Hey, Mama.
The innocent
will flourish when you flow against things.
More traveling.
Ah.
Are you not going to the city again? I've given you my blessings now to go to the city.
Mama.
I want you to go and enter the first bus so that you get there on time and call me.
You see that blessings that you've given me? Let me use it in your house here. Lagos.
What do you mean? You are no more going.
Mama, I had a terrible dream.
Is that so?
Let me stay with you. It's better. Or you want to lose me?
No, God forbid.
Come on, I'm staying here. I'm going nowhere.
You will stay here with me.
Let me stay here. Hey, Mama.
No problem now.
I will not lose you. You will not lose me. I'll be entering the bus in your house. Mommy. Am I the fellow worrying? Them one big balloon. The man got to worry.
Chloe.
You said it earlier on that things will be better here. It will be better. I believe you. Mommy, I believe you, Badje. It will be better.
Who is knocking? I
don't
know. I guess that is
your friend.
No,
she
can't come.
Who is this? Ebuka.
Can they
lay ye? Ebuka! Mami!
Oh, mommy!
Mami!
Ebuka!
Some money! Mami! Eh? Mommy! Oh, did you not allow me? I saw him in my dreams, Mami!
What is he looking for here?
Mommy,
Ebuka! Ebuka!
Go now, Ebuka!
Mommy!
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 There is no smoke without fire. When you see smoke, look for fire. Almost everything has a solution. When you take the right action, you find the solution. That's the way it goes. Only God knows where it's coming from. There's nothing the Almighty cannot do. When you call on Him, He'll help you. He knows the unknown truth, and in time reveal the truth. The wicked will be punished, and the innocent will flourish. When you plot against the innocent, you will not succeed, because God protects the innocent. Yes, indeed. Yes, indeed. You can go ahead with your evil plan and try to hide it as much as you can, but it's just a matter of time, and you will be exposed. Because God, yes, in heaven, when you propose, God alone will dispose. There is nothing the Almighty cannot do. Nothing. When you call on Him, He'll help you. He knows the unknown truth.
Reveal the truth.
The wicked will be punished. And the innocent will flourish.
The
Almighty.